I'll tell you what. Let your old mum get you another drink.
Meg, I love you and I want to marry you.
I love you too.
Well, will you marry me?
Yes.
Good girl.
Oh.
You mean this woman was able to remove your watch from your wrist without you noticing it?
Well, you see, I was asleep.
You must be a very sound sleeper, Miss Bennett.
Well, no, not usually, but... Well, look, I had a couple of drinks with her. I told you I felt sorry for her, and I thought that it...
There, but for the grace of God.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, it seems to me you had more than just a couple, miss. You must have been out cold when she took your watch.
You're here to investigate a robbery, Constable. Not give me a sermon.
Well, I'm sorry, Miss Bennett, but...
What?
Don't you think you could use some help?
Yes. I can use some help in the recovery of my stolen property. That is the reason you're here, the only reason.
Well, we'll certainly do the best we can, Miss Bennett, but... if you don't have the serial numbers for the camera, the watch, or the cassette... there's not much chance of tracing them, I'm afraid. The cash you can forget. As for the jewellery...
Look, I'm not very concerned about the cash and things. But some of the jewellery... Well, it was quite valuable. And I'd be very grateful if you could get it back for me.
You've given me a good description of the various pieces. I'll make sure it's circulated to all the pawn shops and jewelers in the area. You never know. We might turn something up.
Thank you.
We'll let you know. Take my advice, miss. Stay off the hard stuff. Leave it to the salvos to look after the derelicts, eh?
I will.
Jackson, could I speak to you a minute?
Yes, what is it?
Oh, move along, ladies, come on.
Put in a good word for me, kid. Right, now, what's the matter?
Well, I just want to apologise about you and Dad. I behaved rather badly, and I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Are you going to marry Dad?
Yes. Yes, I am.
When?
Well, 4 weeks from Saturday. Well, that's what's planned, anyway.
I'm glad.
Do you really mean it?
Yes, I do. One thing about being cooped up in a place like this, at least it gives you a chance to think. And when you start thinking about other people and not just yourself, I hope you'll be very happy.
Thank you. It could be a little difficult for you. If the rest of the women begin to even think that I'm showing you the slightest favouritism, they could get very upset. And that could make life very difficult for both of us.
I wouldn't expect you to do me any favours.
Well, that's good, Tracy, because I'll be trying not to.
Miss Bennett. Oh, you look awful. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
Well, you look terrible. You're not reporting for duty, surely?
That's precisely what I'm doing.
Are you indeed?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson. I'm perfectly capable of putting in an 8-hour shift.
We'll discuss that in my office.
you'd be relieved to see me with the prison staff situation.
I would be if you were 100% fit to return to duty, but from the look of you, you are nowhere near that.
I'm perfectly all right.
Is that your own opinion, or have you consulted Dr. Marshall?
No, I haven't.
Then, as far as I am concerned, you are still unfit to return to duty until Dr. Marshall advises me otherwise. Now, I suggest you go home and rest until you are fully recovered.
No, please, Mrs. Davidson, I couldn't go home.
You'd better sit down. Obviously, Dr. Marshall's assessment of your condition was understated. You're not just run down, you're on the verge of total exhaustion.
No, it isn't that.
What is it, then?
Mrs. Davidson, I believe I've got a problem.
A problem with alcohol?
Yes, and I'm afraid.
If it's your job you're afraid for, there's no need to be. The department knows nothing of recent events. Your service record is entirely without blemish and will remain so as long as there is no recurrence of your earlier behavior.
Thank you. But don't you see that if you insist on my leaving here, I may never be able to come back.
Vera, you can't stay here indefinitely.
I know, but I can't go back there, not now. I must do some work, Mrs. Davidson. I must do something.
All right, all right. You may resume your duties.
Thank you. Thank you for standing by me.
Vera, what has happened to you?
Well, yesterday I met a woman, a derelict. I'd been drinking and so had she. Well, I don't know why, but I took her back to my flat. We talked. I even began to imagine she was my own mother. Well, finally, I fell asleep. She left. And when she left, she took everything she could lay her hands on. Jewelry, money, anything.
Did you contact the police?
Yes.
Well, I'm sure they'll do their best.
Well, that doesn't matter. That's not the point.
Vera, I'm sorry. I just don't understand.
Well, at first I was angry. I was furious. And then I realized I shouldn't be angry. I should be grateful. Because that dirty, smelly old woman, well, I realized that that could have been me. Unless I do something about myself and do it now.
I see. It's not going to be easy, Vera.
I know.
Come on, Tracey, pull the other one.
It's true.
Well, what'd you have to go and talk to in private then for?
Because I didn't want you to think I was dumb or anything.
You know, we could always ask Mrs. Jackson what you two are on about out there.
And she'd tell you the same thing. I was just getting a few of the rules straight, that's all.
Could have asked one of us.
I suppose.
Besides, if there's one rule Mrs. Jackson wouldn't have mentioned.
What's that?
We don't keep secrets from each other in here.
Not even personal ones?
No, there's no point, because someone's going to find out eventually.
Hey, you lot! There's a story in here about Jacki Nolan.
What's it say?
It says that she is... Woman escapee surrenders. Jacki Nolan, who escaped from legal custody 6 years ago, gave herself up to the authorities on the 21st of this month and was duly dealt with by what can only be regarded as nearsighted and
unyielding
legal system. In the case of Jacki Nolan, justice was indeed blind, totally blind. This young woman... Hey! Some people have got no manners.
Well, what did the rest of it say, then?
It said she's been leading a respectable life for 6 years and that the judge was a bastard.
Yeah?
Or something like that.
Sounds like someone's got a campaign up to get Jacki released.
Hey, that's great.
Is it?
I think so.
Hey, Lizzie, how come this paper hasn't been scissored?
I snitched it out of the staff room.
Yeah, well, you better get it back there before anyone sees.
What's going on here?
Ah, oh, Miss Bennett. So you're back. We thought you were away. Sick.
You've all quite finished? As you can see, I am back. And I'm no more inclined to put up with your insolence than I was before. So if any of you have got any smart remarks, I suggest you keep them to yourselves. Do I make myself clear?
We just want to say we're glad to see you back, Miss Bennett.
Thank you, Smith. And you can show your appreciation by getting on with your work. Where did this come from? Answer me, Morris.
I found it, Miss Bennett.
That's a lie.
I took it out of the staff room.
I see. Then you'd better put it back, Birdsworth. Oh, I see that you're back with us, Doreen. Quite the little happy family again, isn't it? Let's keep it that way, girls.
What do you know? Old vinegar's gone soft.
I wouldn't count on it.
Vera will be all right.
No, but I do agree with her that she's better off in here than at home.
I don't like it. I think it's a security risk.
Oh, to an extent, but we are short-staffed and...
And if she really wants to come back to work...
She does, but still, I think you should keep an eye on her.
Don't worry, I will. Oh, by the way, I called in to see Julian Phillips yesterday.
Oh, yes? How did you get on?
Practically came to blows. I tried to tell him that I was only interested in helping Jacki, but he wouldn't listen. He ordered me out of the shop.
Well, that's amazing. I would have thought he'd be the first to feel the courts have been too hard on her.
Yeah, so would I. Think there's any chance that we might be able to do something to help?
Well, not you and I personally, but there is a meeting of the prison reform group this evening. We could go along and see if they could help.
The PRG? They're a bunch of ratbags.
Not entirely. They do have access to barristers and such like. It's worth a try. I've worked with them before on cases. They're not as bad as you think.
All right, if you say so. We'll give it a go, eh?
Oh, well, why don't we meet in reception after work?
Right. Go, Beck.
Jim, respects and... Could I see you in your office for a moment,
yes,
please?
Yes, of course, Mrs. Jackson. Now, Meg, what can I do for you?
I want some time off. I've got a couple of days owing to me, and I was wondering if, well, if it's at all possible, whether I could take them, say, 4 weeks from next Saturday?
4 weeks? Well, you seem very definite about the time. Is there a particular reason?
Mm-hmm. I'm getting married.
Bob Morris?
Yes.
Oh, Meg, congratulations. I'm delighted for both of you. He's a good man.
Yes, yes, he is. Oh, and don't worry about Tracey. I've spoken to her, and I don't think there'll be any problems on that account.
Oh, I'm glad to hear it. Have you decided where you're going to spend your honeymoon?
Oh, no, no. It's all been a bit of a rush.
Oh, not too rushed, I hope.
No, no, I don't think so.
Miss Bennett?
Mr. Fletcher?
Good grief, what a mess.
I'm sorry, that was me. I just had a slight accident. I'll clean it up in a minute.
You all right?
Yes, I'm fine.
Well, was somebody asking? Can I make you a cup of coffee?
Would you?
Yes, of course.
Thanks. Nothing much has changed since I've been away.
Oh, and lucky for you that it hasn't. You know, you didn't have a job to come back to. If Mrs. Davidson...
I'm well aware of what Mrs. Davidson's done for me. I've already thanked her and expressed my regrets for what happened. So if you don't mind, I'd rather not talk about it.
Sorry. Good news about Meg, though, isn't it?
Meg?
Yeah. She's going to marry Bob Morris. Hadn't you heard?
No, I hadn't. That's going to be nice for Tracey Morris, isn't it?
How do you mean?
Having her stepmother around to take care of her, there'll be a few favours.
Meg Jackson, like most of the staff here, is a professional. and as such wouldn't allow her personal involvement to affect her work no more than you or I would.
Maybe. But then it's nothing to do with me anyway.
Judge Cawthorn? Oh, hello, Julian. How are you? Oh, I'm glad to hear it, my boy. And how is the delightful Sarah?
Well, as a matter of fact, it's Sarah, or rather Jacki, I was calling about.
Jacki? She changed her name for some reason?
Yes, she has. Her real name's Jacki Nolan.
Hmm. Not the Jacki Nolan I've been reading about in this morning's paper. My word, she seems to have got herself into a spot of bother. Mind you, I don't exactly go along with this reporter fellow's nonsense about her being a miscarriage of justice. It strikes me she's, well, came in for a rather heavy treatment.
Yes, she has, and I was rather hoping that we might be able to call on you for some help. You see, I intend lodging an appeal with the governor in council. I've already got Anthony Vickers going into bat for us, and I was hoping that you might be able to help out in some way.
Of course, my boy, of course. Talents such as hers shouldn't be kept locked up. I tell you what, why don't you come round the club, have a spot of lunch with me? You can tell me the full story. We should be able to nut something out between us.
Well, thank you, Judge. I'd really appreciate that. At what time? Yes, 12:30 would be fine. Okay. Bye.
I just wish people wouldn't interfere, that's all. I just want to do my time, get it over with, and get on with what's left of my life.
But if you can get time off your sentence...
If, there are too many ifs. If we do this or if we do that, then maybe. No, no way. Get on with it, get it over, and get out. That's all I'm interested in now.
Don't you think you're being a bit ungrateful? There are people outside who obviously care about you. I mean, the papers are on site already, and who knows, maybe.
Maybe, maybe. There you go again.
Oh, take it easy, Jacki. The kid's only trying to help.
I don't want her help or anyone else's help. So just leave me alone, will you?
What's your problem, Nolan?
Nothing, Miss Bennett.
What are you doing here, Morris?
Nothing, Miss Bennett.
Precisely. What are you supposed to be doing?
Nothing. I was just talking to Jacki.
I see. Reading newspapers. Chattering during working hours, not to mention telling lies. You're getting into some very bad habits, Morris. I suppose you think your special relationship with Mrs. Jackson entitles you to behave in this manner.
That's unfair.
Don't you answer me.
I
warned you. You can scrub the first floor corridors
but
for
I
that
didn't...
and the second. Do you also want to do the third? Now report to me after work.
What did I do?
Oh. That is a very good question.
What's the matter? Can't you tear yourself away from the place?
No, I'm waiting for Mrs. Davidson, actually.
Oh.
Yeah, we're going to a meeting of the PRG tonight.
Yes, perhaps you'd care to join us, Miss Bennett.
No, thank you, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, well, as you wish. You'd better go home and have a good night's rest.
Well, I was thinking of going out and having a meal first.
I'm going out with a few of the girls for a count of tea. Would you like to join us? A couple of drinks might do you good.
No, thanks.
Well, come along, Mr. Fletcher. All this talk of food is making me hungry. We won't have a chance to eat till after the meeting.
No.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Which hotel are you going to?
Oh, just down to the local. Food's quite good, though. Sure you wouldn't like to come?
No. No, thanks. I'm a bit tired, really.
Fair enough. How was the first day back?
Well, I think it went quite well. I managed to let the women know that the amnesty is over.
Amnesty?
Never mind. Good night.
And considering the fact that she's led a normal, even exemplary life for the past 6 years since she escaped.
And the fact that she turned herself in.
Well, precisely. To me, it's a perfect example of self-rehabilitation. It certainly doesn't warrant the severity of the sentence that was meted out to her. I mean, you're a legal man. You're a solicitor. What do you think?
I couldn't agree more.
Well, do you think there's anything that you and the PRG can do to help?
Yes, yes, I think we can probably get a bit of pressure brought. Rouse public opinion. Look, I'm in the chair tonight, so I want to get this meeting underway as soon as I can. We'll get through the main business as quickly as we possibly can, and we'll let you toss your little number to the group for open discussion.
Good, okay? Thanks, I'd appreciate that.
Right. Okay, everybody, you'd like to grab a chair? Got a lot of business to get through tonight. Oh, we have a newcomer this evening, Mr. Jim Fletcher. He'll be addressing you a little later on.
This matter to your attention, I hope you won't just see it as an opportunity for, if you'll pardon the expression, sticking it up the authorities. I'm of the opinion, and your chairman agrees with me, that the sentence imposed upon Jacki Nolan was severe in the extreme. By coming here tonight, I hope to enlist your support for Jacki Nolan, and to listen to any suggestions that you might have in getting the court's decisions reversed, particularly the additional sentence that was imposed. Thank you.
Well, does anybody have any ideas to put forward? Yes, Myra.
Mr. Chairman, I think it's pretty obvious from what Mr. Fletcher's told us that the Jacki Nolan case is a pretty urgent one. I think we should get on to it as
soon as
possible.
Who's the woman?
Myra Desmond. She's one of the prime movers for the PRG.
Yeah, I was speaking to her before the meeting started. Seemed like a pretty well-educated woman.
Well, she is. She studied for her HSC at one of our more exclusive women's colleges.
Really?
One second,
which
then?
One?
Wentworth Detention Centre.
Favour seconds. All those in favour? Against? Carry.
Right. Well, we'll work out the main drive once the committee's been formed. Meanwhile, I don't think it's going to do any harm to engage in a bit of softening up. Have a batch of posters printed, slapped up around the city, that sort of thing. Free Jacki Nolan.
Surely that's illegal without a permit of some kind.
Any objections, Mr. Fletcher?
What? No. No, of course not.
Fine. Well, I'll get on to that first thing in the morning. I've got a couple of friends in the printing business that owe me a favour.
They don't print funny money, do they?
Not anymore, Mrs. D.
Deaf or something. I can't hear myself think.
Don't tell me you're still writing that letter to Ellen and Josie.
What have I?
Well, you've been at it for a week.
Oh, I just don't seem to be able to get started.
Well, why don't you try Dear Ellen and Josie?
Smart ass.
Anyone seen Tracey Morris?
Oh, come off it, Mrs. Jackson. She won't be finished yet. It'll take her a couple of days at least.
Well, finished what?
Miss Bennett put her on extra duties, and at the rate she's going, poor little love will be scrubbing away for the whole of next week.
Miss Bennett? I see.
Listen, what is it between you two?
Whatever it is, Miss Bennett doesn't like it. I never saw a pick on anyone so fast.
Yeah, she seems to think you're protecting young Tracey.
Are you two talking about?
Well, like Lizzie said, the only reason we can see for the kid copping extra duties has got something to do with you. Tracey's acting as if her lips are sealed.
So what's the big secret?
There's no big secret. If Tracy's done something wrong, then she has to be punished.
But she hasn't, has she, girls?
No, she never did anything. Vera just jumped her, and as far as we can make out, it's got something to do with you.
Yeah, I don't reckon it's fair.
Doreen, Bev, Rita, you come with me.
Now, maybe we'll find out what's going on.
What did she do?
I don't know. I
must be something awful, though. Vera's really got it in for her. She says if she doesn't get it all done by tonight, she'll do the third floor as well tomorrow night. I don't think the poor kid's got a hope in hell of finishing.
Tracey, why did Miss Bennett put you on extra duties?
I don't know, Mrs. Jackson. I really don't.
Very well. Well, I've bought you some help. I think you could use it.
Oh, please, you know what you said before.
You just get on with your work, Tracey, and you leave this to me. Now, before you do anything, there's something you all ought to know. I'm getting married soon.
Oh, gee, Mrs. Jackson, that's terrific. What's it got to do with us?
Well, I'm marrying Tracy's father. So you can understand why Tracy doesn't want you to think I'm doing her any special favours. I just want to make it clear that I am not ordering you to work.
So you want us to go back to the rec room?
I mean you can use your free time to do whatever you wish. It's up to you.
There's nothing much on telly anyway.
Well, come on, we haven't got all day. Especially you, Morris. You've got a job to do before the work bell goes. I suggest you miss breakfast.
Oh, that's all right, Miss Bennett. It's all done.
Both floors?
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe you. The rest of you get into breakfast. Now, listen to me. When I instruct you to do something, you do it.
It is done, Miss Bennett. Clean as a whistle. You ought to go and have a look at it yourself.
What's this got to do with you, Birdsworth?
Nothing. Only I couldn't help on account of me poor old Tiki, you know. Sorry.
I didn't instruct anyone to help.
Yeah, but Mrs. Jackson said we could volunteer.
You haven't heard the last of this, Morris.
Are you suggesting that Mrs. Jackson is giving Tracy Morris preferential treatment?
It's not like Meg, I know, but what other reason could there be for her behaviour? I was justified in giving Morris extra duties. The fact that Meg didn't countermand my orders bears that out. Instead, she coerced the women into volunteering to help, and they're not very happy about it either.
I've never known you to be worried about whether the women were happy or not before.
I'm not so stupid as to hand out punishment without proper justification. No, I'm only thinking of Meg and her record of service. It must be a terrible strain on her having to cope with a prospective stepdaughter amongst the inmates.
I'm sure Mrs. Jackson will be very grateful for your concern. Thank you, Miss Bennett. I'll take it from here. Oh, and would you bring Doreen Burns down, please? I'd like to have a chat with her.
Very well, Mrs. Davidson.
No, I reckon old Vinegar's up to something. How come she didn't bite our heads off?
Probably forgot to put her teeth in this morning.
I hope she doesn't make any trouble for Mrs. Jackson, that's all.
No, of course she won't. She better watch her step with Davo after what happened last time.
Hey, when did you say the wedding was, Tracy?
4 weeks Saturday.
Well, you better do yourself a favour and put in an application for leave if you want to get there.
Can I get leave?
You can apply for it. I reckon you stand a pretty fair chance.
Yeah, and we better start thinking about a wedding present.
You could always give them a pair of government sheets with built-in ventilation.
Then the department will be forced to replace them. And I don't think I could stand the luxury.
Hang on. That's not a bad idea.
What? Give them these?
No, not those. Get some cotton or something and make a pair of sheets and some pillowcases to match.
Hey, yeah, and we could embroider something on them, you know, like his and hers.
Or to whom it may concern, or this end up.
Yeah, don't be like that.
Oh, sorry.
The only trouble is, where are we going to get the material?
Pinch it from the store. Where else?
No, not the blue. Something more neutral. I'll call you back.
Good morning. Look, don't you think it's time that we set our differences aside and...
Yes, could I have the police, please?
Now, you listen to me for a minute. All right, so you hate my guts. Maybe you got good reason to. But surely the important thing now is Jacki.
Jacki has always been the most important thing.
All right, so we both want to see her out and free. That's what I want to talk to you about.
Okay, so talk.
I've been in touch with the prison reform group.
Oh, what the hell use can they be?
They can move public opinion. Believe me, they're very influential.
The public is not going to be influenced by a bunch of ex-con ratbags. So if that's the best you can do, forget about it. You want to influence public opinion, go to the top like I did. But that's out of your league, isn't it, Fletcher? So why don't you scurry on back to your prison reform group and get them to lobby about more meat in the prison stew. I'll get Jacki out of here without your help or your red raggers.
We could combine forces. Think what we could achieve if we worked together on this.
And let you take the credit for getting her out. Let her think what a good fellow you are. Not likely. You're the bastard who put her in there in the first place. And by the time I've finished with you, she's going to know just how big a bastard you really are. Now, are you leaving? Or shall I call the police?
Miss Bennett catches you reading that, we'll all be scrubbing floors tonight.
Oh, the trick is not to get caught, isn't it? Oh, hello, they're having another go at Jacki.
What are they saying this time?
Looks like they've got a public debate going. Whole swag of letters to the editor. You know, whoever's doing this is stirring up quite a hornet's nest. You can come out in front.
I wish they'd stop interfering. I've made my decision, they should respect that.
Well, I'll tell you what, if someone was putting this effort into me, I'd be shouting it from the rooftop.
Burns, the governor wants to see you. I'd like to make a phone call, Miss Bennett.
Later.
Don't you ever put your hands on me again, Nolan.
Oh, come on, Miss Bennett, you've got a problem. You could take her to the phone while you're taking Doreen to the governor's office.
And don't you start telling me what to do. Unless, of course, you want to spend some more time in the pound.
What's the problem, Miss Bennett?
There's no problem.
Yes, there is, Mr. Fletcher. Miss Bennett has refused permission for me to make my phone call.
I did not refuse, Nolan. I simply said later.
It's all right, Miss Bennett. I understand. If you haven't got the time to take Nolan to the phone, I'll do it. Come on, Nolan.
Burns, move!
You are not becoming a political football, darling.
Oh, come off it, Julian. I know who you've got working for you.
Correction, my dear, working for you.
Correction again, Julian. Working for themselves. I'm the one dangling on the end of the rope, and whichever way it swings, I'm the one that gets splattered against the wall. So I want this stopped now. Do you understand?
Be reasonable, Jacki. We stand every chance of getting a vice-regal pardon. That's if we can keep that bunch of radicals out of the way.
Are you referring to Judge Cawthorn and company, or what?
No, of course not.
Well, who then?
Well, you'd better ask your friend Jim Fletcher about that.
What's he got to do with it?
Oh, he's been doing his own feeble bit of interfering. But as I said, ask him.
I will. And as for your interference, Julian, I want it stopped now. Well, tell me about your group of radicals, Mr. Fletcher. Well?
Yes, well, that'd be the PRG.
The what?
The prison reform group. Mrs. Davidson and I...
She's in this as well.
But would you calm down? We're only trying to help you, you know.
What does it take to get through to you people? I don't want your help, Mr. Fletcher, or anyone else's. So will you, for pity's sake, leave me alone?
I don't know, Mrs. Davidson. Everything I do, I seem to muck up. I mean, I've been out on parole twice and landed back in here through being stupid. I mucked up my marriage and I can't even hold a job on the outside.
Oh, Doreen, you have to try.
Well, I do try, Mrs. Davidson.
Then you'll have to try harder. Work at it. With your attitude, you'll make yourself a loser before you get into the event. Now, there's a book in the prison library. I want you to read it.
The Power of Positive Thinking...
Oh, Mrs. Davidson. Read it, and then I want you to think about furthering your education. Well, Ros Coulson was able to get her HSE, Doreen.
Yeah, but she was smart, and she had Mr. Reed to help her.
And I am more than willing to help you. Erica Davidson?
Yes, Mr. Douglas.
Oh, I was rather hoping you'd get something closer to the city. Yes, yes, I quite understand. Well, Barnhurst it is, then. Thank you, Ted. No, no, tomorrow will be fine. Goodbye. Well, that's all now, thank you, Doreen. And remember,
Read that book. And if you do decide to undertake a course, it can only be to your ultimate benefit.
Thanks, Mrs. Davidson.
Julie, would you prepare the necessary transferal papers for an inmate, please? Thank you.
You reckon you convinced that friend of yours to lay off?
Oh, I don't know. Perhaps not. He thinks he needs me to help him with a business. And then there's all the political intrigue. Oh, maybe it's gone too far already.
Just can't stop the roller coaster, eh? Who's this other group that's campaigning for you?
Oh, them. The PRG trying to get in on the act.
Well, they're a pretty good lot to have on side.
I don't want them on side. I don't want anyone on side.
Oh, okay. Nothing to do with me if you end up in here forever.
Oh, you've been a long time. What you got there?
Oh, it's a book Mrs. Davidson wants me to read.
The Power of Positive Thinking. What's it like?
Oh, I don't know. I can't see what the bloke's trying to get at.
Oh, look. You okay, Doreen?
Oh, yeah.
Did Dave O say something to upset you?
No, it was just sort of a pep talk, you know. But while I was there, she got a phone call. Sounds to me as though someone's being transferred to Barnhurst.
Who?
I don't know. She couldn't throw me out or anything because it would have looked real funny. But she was being that cagey, I reckon it was one of our mob.
Well, that settles it then. We'll send out the invitation at the end of the week, huh?
Right. And the best thing of all is that we've got Tracey.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the time. I must go.
You know, this night shift's playing havoc with my social life.
Well, it won't be for much longer.
I'll drop you off, right?
Thanks.
Which means we don't have to rush off straight away, right?
Yes, we do. I'll be running late, and I don't want to get the sack at this stage of the game.
Oh, I wouldn't mind. You know that, don't you?
Yes, I know. We've already agreed. I'm staying on at Wentworth for the time being at least.
All right, you're the boss.
All right, come
on. I might drop in and see Tracey tomorrow, okay?
All right, then. I'll arrange it when I get there.
Okay. There you go.
Tracey? What's wrong, honey?
Apparently I'm being transferred.
Transferred? Where to?
Some place called Barnhurst.
Why?
They don't like relatives in the same prison.
What relatives?
Dad's marrying Mrs. Jackson. I don't understand it. I promise I wouldn't take advantage of her. What does she want to have me transferred for?
Well, honey, maybe it's not up to her.
Well, who's it up to then?
Mrs. Davidson's the boss.
But she knew about Dad, Mrs. Jackson, before, and she didn't have me transferred then.
Uh-huh, but they weren't getting married then.
It's not fair. Anyway, it won't be for ages yet.
Yeah, this is all you're doing, isn't it, Vera? You've always had it in for her.
Rubbish. You're just a spoilt brat, Morris. But believe me, I'd rather have you here where I could teach you a thing or two than in some soft spot like Barnhurst.
Barnhurst? Soft?
They were soft enough to let you walk out.
Yeah, sure. They just opened the gates for me.
Don't be smart, or you might find yourself going with Morris.
Then it is me. I am the one being transferred.
I didn't say that.
But that's what you meant, isn't it? Why? I haven't done anything.
All I'm saying is that I can understand why Mrs. Jackson wants you out of the way. You're nothing but an embarrassment to her.
She's lying, honey. You know she's lying.
Look, Mrs. Jackson's a good officer, love. If you can trust anyone, you can trust her.
She's one in a million.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, Mrs. Bloody Jackson, what about me? I'm the one being transferred. No one gives a damn.
Let her calm down. Otherwise, next thing she'll be saying it's all your fault.
Well, Tracey, what's the matter?
Just stay away from me.
I was just going to tell you, your father's visiting you tomorrow.
Well, you better give him a roadmap to Barnhurst, then.
Oh, come back here.
Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine. What was that about Barnhurst?
Oh, come off it, Mrs. Jackson. You really had me fooled yesterday. Don't worry, the others still believe you. They still think the sun shines
That's
out
enough,
of you.
Morris.
What's going on?
She's being transferred to Barnhurst tomorrow morning. And not before time, either. Striking an officer. That'll get you at least a month in solitary confinement. Now, come on. Now, here it is. Now, get used to it. There's one just like it at Barnhurst, and I'll make sure your reservation's made.
You don't have to stay here, Tracey. You can go back to your cell. And there'll be no solitary confinement when she gets to Barnhurst, either.
I hope you realise that I'll be reporting the fact that she struck an officer.
I didn't see her strike an officer.
But you can't
And I wouldn't go making any reports about anyone if I were you.
What do you mean by that?
I mean, if you did, I would be putting in my own report to the department about a certain officer being drunk on duty.
You wouldn't.
Try me. Tracey? Now, I don't know how you got it into your head that I'm responsible for this transfer, but believe it or not, I had nothing to do with it, although I am probably the cause of why it's happened. I'm sorry. Now, I'll see what I can do. I'll speak to the governor in the morning, but I can't promise anything. Now, if I can't stop the transfer, it means you won't be seeing your father tomorrow. Is there any message you'd like me to pass on to him?
Just tell him that I love him, and please, Mrs. Jackson, don't tell him about what just happened.
Of course not. You better go along to your cell.
I made the decision to have Tracey transferred. Nobody did it for me.
Yes, but you can't deny that Vera had a lot to do with it.
I have been concerned about the situation for some time now.
Concerned that I'd give Tracey preferential treatment?
No. Concerned that anything you did involving Tracey could be wrongly interpreted by others. Believe me, Meg, I didn't take this decision lightly.
Look, I know you're probably acting according to the regulations, but it's not official yet. Our relationship, I mean. So please, couldn't you give Tracey more time to get used to it? It's not too late to change your mind.
I'm afraid it is.
Stan? Right. Handbag. Containing one purse. Lipstick.
Tracey,
brooch.
I tried.
Miscellaneous jewelry.
I'm sorry.
Cassette recorder. Necklace. Money totaling $15.25.
Hello, Phillips.
Good morning, Mr. Phillips. It's Maggie Kirk here, Anthony Vickers' secretary.
I was just about to call him.
Well, Parliament's sitting, sir, but he's asked me to pass on a message to you.
Yes, I can imagine what it's about.
Yes, well, it seems he's none too happy about a particular newspaper article.
I absolutely agree with him. Look, would you please assure him that I had nothing to do with it and tell him I'm about to deal with the people responsible? You could also tell him it won't happen again.
Well, I don't really understand it, Meg. Still, there's not much I do understand about the workings of a prison. Anyway, Barnhurst isn't at the end of the earth, is it?
Well, that's not what Tracey thinks right now.
Yeah, well, I'll just have to get out there and see her as soon as possible.
Well, perhaps we could both drive up there on my next day off.
Oh, good idea. Look, Meg, thanks for waiting back to tell me. I know how tired you must be. Look, my car's over here. I'll drop you, huh?
See Mr. Fletcher. The name's Phillips.
Right, sir.
Oh, it's you.
I suppose you've read this. Female escapee, top MP linked. You and your bunch of interfering ex-convicts, you're ruining everything I've managed to do for Jacki by plastering the city with your obscene graffiti and publishing this trash.
That headline's misleading. The article's not bad. It's all about a talent as an interior designer.
And about the demands of the PRG. Demanding changes to the law. Demanding improved conditions for prisoners. Demanding debates with members of parliament. Debates on what? Jacki Nolan? Oh, no. She's just the ham and the sandwich now. This is the chance they've been waiting for. They don't give a bugger if she gets off or not. Neither, quite obviously, to you.
No, you listen to me.
No, you listen to me for a change. One more article like this. One more poster, and I lose the support of the only people who can help Jacki get out of here. I lose them, and she rots in here for the next 3 years. And you will be entirely to blame.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. And the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together. Sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the night.